Skarin, you're not gonna have one of those fits, are you? Because I'm not feeling well as it is. Not that we don't appreciate you freeing us, but wounds from Legion weapons are slow to heal.
Who draws me away from the tables of Valhalla? Well, Viking, now go crush some Legion skulls. I have earned my place in Valhalla, warrior. Have you? Mastered this move, warrior. Go now, and perhaps I may yet see you in Valhalla.
crossing and take it to the dragon summoning stones to the south. We must see if they will come to you. This dragon is known as Ari. He is young, only 800 summers old, but he is strong and loyal. The dragons of the Elder Days required greater offerings to fight in the wars of Midgard's youth. Find such dragon runes now, and we will call forth their fire once more. Behold your army. Those that stand before us are loyal and brave. They will fight to the death for you, my mortal. Shaman. Once loyal to the Asgardian gods, they now reside in the service of Hel. Through their power, they are able to draw Hellspawn from the underworld below and reinforce Legion numbers. Defeat them swiftly, or they will summon up insurmountable odds against us.
Thank you. Asgardian! Only you can reach their shaman! Get to him and take him out!
this? Let your pet defend himself, Hel. Do you fear your blessing will not be enough?
We will not be distracted by your petty vengeance, Freya.
You dare speak to me of vengeance?
Oh, my quest is not for vengeance, Freya. It is for justice. Justice for the whole of Midgard. Justice from your Asgard, from your Valhalla. In my Midgard, all will be treated as warriors. As...
You please me, Skarin. You are truly worthy of my blessing. Hel has retreated to the Isle of Galcliff with her tail between her legs, and you must follow. Legion forces are stronger there, and have already turned much of Midgard's bounty to their own bestial needs. But...
Once, within Drakan, there rested the soul of a mortal man. A mortal whose courage and honor moved Freya herself. When she chose him as her blessed champion, Drakan's loyalty to Freya knew no bounds. As his conquests in her name grew, so too did Drakan's affections. For it seemed to him that to look upon Freya was to look upon the face of love itself. But mortal hearts are fragile. They are not meant to touch the divine. When Freya spurned Drakan's love and released him from his bonds, he wandered the lands in anguish. Obsession grew to madness, madness to emptiness. And that is when Hel, Queen of the Underworld, found him and made him her own. Hel offered him her protection, and in return, he'll become her harbinger and lead her dark army against Midgard. For Drakan, this was not only a chance to relive his former glories, but a chance for revenge. The more Drakan fought in Hel's name, the further away from Midgard he grew, until he became more akin to beast than man. It is said that only the giver may undo a divine blessing of immortality. Yet there are weapons forged for the undoing of many things in this world. Blessings, curses, even such weapons that can undo a goddess's will.
This is the Isle of Galcliff, Skarin, home to the settlement of Holdenfort. Once this vibrant port teemed with life, now it is under Legion control and a place of only pain and death. Once you have gathered...
Forge is heated. What can I do for you? Looking for a bit more firepower, are you? Put your trust in fire, I say.
How can I help you, Viking?
Ah, I haven't seen you in a while.
Ah, delicious. Good day to you, warrior.